The Justice Secretary insists Express Rail Link co-location arrangements have solid legal grounds. London judge considering whether terminally ill baby could spend final days at hospice. And 12-time Grand Slam champion Novak Djokovic will sit out the rest of the tennis season. Hello, good evening. The Justice Secretary insisted today the proposed co-location arrangements for immigration, customs and quarantine facilities at the Express Rail Link's West Kowloon terminus are in line with the basic law. Rimsky-Yun is also not worried about any legal challenges against the arrangements. Caleb Leung has more.
Under the government's co-location proposal, a quarter of the floor area of the Express Rail Link's West Kowloon terminus will be leased to mainland authorities. Secretary for Justice Rimsky-Yun said today that under Article 7 of the Basic Law, the land within the SA are state property and the SAR government is responsible for its management. Therefore, Hong Kong has the authority to lease part of the terminus to mainland authorities. It is just like a landlord has leased a house to someone and later he finds himself in need of more space, so he asks the tenant to lease a room to him, Yun said. The Justice Secretary said the landlord possesses such power, and legally he doesn't see why Hong Kong cannot lease some land back to mainland authorities. He also believes the government's proposal has solid legal grounds, and he is not worried about legal challenges. However, Chairman of the Civic Party, Alan Leung, believes the proposal is not in line with the basic law.
The co-location arrangements proposed by the government run foul of Article 18 of the Basic Law, which clearly provides that no mainland laws would be practiced within the territorial limits of the Hong Kong Special Administrative Region. It is totally unacceptable for the co-location arrangements to be put in place that would allow mainland laws to travel with the high-speed rail cars to different parts.
At least three people filed applications for judicial reviews of the co-location proposal today, including Cheung Chau resident Kwok Chuk Kin. However, University of Hong Kong legal scholar Eric Cheung doesn't see a chance of successfully challenging the proposal legally. He said based on past experience, the National People's Congress Standing Committee can interpret the basic law at any time. Therefore, it can be said that the government is legally invincible. Caleb Leung, TVB News.
The government says the Express Rail Link trains will run for 228 trips between Hong Kong and Guangzhou on the first day. Hong Kong will be operating 9 XRL trains, which will mainly be used for short-haul services. For short-haul services, a train will depart from the West Kowloon terminus to Futian, Shenzhen North, Humen in Dongguan, and Guangzhou South Station. Meanwhile, long-haul services will be provided by the mainland. Secretary for Transport and Housing, Frank Chan, says that in mainland-controlled areas at the terminus, passengers could attempt to bypass the firewall if they want to browse overseas websites. Land reduction is the answer to boosting land supply in Hong Kong. That's a research finding from two University of Hong Kong professors. They say reclaiming a local reservoir could provide 300,000 more housing units. New towns developed in the 1980s, such as Sha Tin and Tuen Mun, sit on reclaimed land. Two university professors who studied Hong Kong's land reclamation from the 19th century to 2015 concluded the method is the answer to the city's housing shortage. The example is the extra 300,000 housing units that can be built if the Plover Cove Reservoir is reclaimed. But what about the environmental impact?
As soon as you transform a pristine virgin maritime ecology into a man-made artificial water body, the original value of ecology is already written off. We have to compare, on the one hand, ecological values and also the needs for development, right? For people, better housing of Hong Kong. As human beings, it's also the center of ecology. If you cancel human beings and talk about ecology, I think you're talking about nonsense.
They said another possible way to boost land supply is to regain privately owned land in the new territories by refusing to renew leases that expire in 2047.
In the new territories, there are a lot of agricultural land or brownfield that are not being developed. Governments should not give them another 50 years for the existing use.
The scholars also urged the chief executive to set up and lead a government body that will oversee strategic planning and communicate their land supply ideas to the public on a regular basis. Environmental group GreenSense is against filling Hong Kong's second largest reservoir for housing purposes. It called that suggestion nonsensical as it disregards safe and stable drinking water supplies. Television Broadcasts Limited has entered into a partnership with a leading Hollywood production company to produce a slate of television serials. TVB Chairman Charles Chan said the company's production base has always remained in Hong Kong. The joint venture with Imagine Entertainment will provide a new opportunity for collaboration in TV projects in the US. TVB will have the rights to release, reproduce, distribute, broadcast and use the TV programs under the joint venture by Imagine in mainland China, Taiwan, Hong Kong and Macau. Imagine was founded by award-winning filmmakers Brian Grazer and Ron Howard. It boasts an impressive portfolio of blockbusters including Apollo 13, American Gangster and The Da Vinci Code. The Ombudsman has launched an investigation into the Housing Department's arrangement for using idle spaces as storerooms at public housing estates. Here's Rachel Lowe.
Are public spaces at public housing estates being put to good use? Here, on the lower floors of some housing blocks at Oymen Estate in Ho Man Tin, we found a large cluster of adjoining idle spaces. This resident says sometimes the unused spaces become shelters for the homeless. The Office of the Ombudsman says it's the same at some other public housing estates. There are storerooms scattered around the estate buildings, with interior layouts similar to those of ordinary rental housing units. That's because the building designs of some public housing estates in the early days have often included some idle spaces that do not meet all the statutory requirements for domestic units under the building's ordinance. Over the years, the housing department has converted these spaces into storerooms for letting out to tenants, for storing furniture and household items. But the ombudsman noted that the vacancy rates of these storerooms are rather high. Considering the low demand for the storerooms, the ombudsman questioned whether the housing department had adopted appropriate measures to better utilize such spaces all these years. In a statement released today, the ombudsman, Connie Lau, said spaces at public housing estates are precious resources, and the department has a duty to properly manage these resources. The ombudsman's office hopes its probe into the issue will help identify possible areas for improvement. Rachel Ng, B News.
Turning overseas now, in Britain, the parents of terminally ill baby Carly Gard conceded he will die in a hospice and not at home as they had begged for. The lawyer says they found a doctor and nursing team who will look after Charlie in hospice. This after the hospital said the parents' request to provide life support treatment at home is impractical. The fate of the 11-month-old with a rare genetic disease has been the subject of a bitter dispute between his parents and a London hospital. It's prevented his parents from taking Charlie to America, where they insist an experimental treatment would have given him a fighting chance of survival. A decision by a High Court judge is expected soon. The US Senate was finally able to move forward somewhat on the long-promised legislation to repeal and replace the Affordable Care Act known as Obamacare. But it couldn't have been done without the dramatic appearance of Arizona Senator John McCain, who returned to Capitol Hill for the first time since being diagnosed with brain cancer. Alan Buckner reports.
On this vote, the yeas are 50 and the nays are 50. Senate being equally divided, the vice president votes in the affirmative and the motion is agreed to.
With two Republicans joining all 48 Democrats in opposing the bill, it took Vice President Mike Pence to break the deadlock. It wouldn't have got that far without the help of Senator John McCain, who returned to the Senate after recently having surgery for brain cancer. But it's a narrow victory on a simple procedural matter to move forward with the health care debate. Despite his yes vote, McCain took a lecturing tone afterwards, and it appeared he hardly saw success assured for any proposed legislation after weeks of misfires.
Let's trust each other. Let's return to regular order. We've been spinning our wheels on too many important issues because we keep trying to find a way to win without help from across the aisle. That's an approach that's been employed by both sides, mandating legislation from the top down without any support from the other side, with all the parliamentary maneuvers that requires. We're getting nothing done, my friends. We're getting nothing done.
A much broader proposal put forward by Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell to repeal and replace Obamacare fell well short of the 60 votes that would have been needed. 9 Republicans voted against it. Still, the outcome was a huge relief for President Donald Trump, who did what he loves to do in these instances. He went on a victory lap.
Finally! You think that's easy? That's not easy. We're now one step closer to liberating our citizens from this Obamacare nightmare.
But there still remain many questions about whether Republicans can muster the votes necessary to pass any of the various approaches to repeal and replace Obamacare. Alan McNeil, TVB News.
The U.S. House of Representatives has voted to slap Russia with additional financial sanctions. The penalties are aimed at punishing Moscow for interfering in the 2016 presidential election and its military aggression in Ukraine and Syria. Lawmakers also voted to ensure President Trump can't lift the sanctions without first securing permission from Congress. Trump supports sanctioning Russia, but says this bill infringes on his executive authority. The measure now heads to the Senate for action. U.S. President Donald Trump is piling on the pressure to get his Attorney General, Jeff Sessions, to resign. He insists Sessions is a lame duck cabinet member after he recused himself from the Russian investigation. Sonia Otero reports.
It appears Jeff Sessions' days are numbered. Trump first began belittling him in tweets, angry with the AG for recusing himself from the Russian probe. Now Trump is using public humiliation to push Sessions to quit.
But I am disappointed in the Attorney General. He should not have recused himself. And if he was going to recuse himself, he should have told me prior to taking office. And I would have quite simply picked somebody else. I think it's unfair to the presidency, and that's the way I feel.
Since he's no use in the Russia investigation, Trump says Sessions needs to prove he's still worthy by at least going after whistleblowers.
I want the Attorney General to be much tougher on the leaks from intelligence agencies.
But one Democratic lawmaker believes Trump is plotting to replace Sessions with an attorney general willing to end the Russia collusion probe.
Many Americans must be wondering if the president is trying to pry open the office of attorney general to appoint someone during the August recess who will fire special counsel Mueller and shut down the Russian investigation.
But that scenario might trigger a constitutional crisis.
It would force Republicans on the Hill, Senate leadership, House leadership, who to this point have largely backed the president, to really face a lot of tough questions whether or not they're going to support someone who, if he does all this, would potentially be plunging the country into a constitutional crisis.
Experts say Trump is acting like he's guilty.
If President Trump has nothing to worry about this Russian investigation, and he's truly innocent of any kind of conspiracy with the Russians, he should welcome this investigation.
Sessions was the first senator to endorse Trump for the presidency, and those close to him say he's deeply hurt by the president's comments. Trump does have the power to fire Sessions, but it's clear he's pushing him to resign voluntarily.
But we will. What happens? Time will tell.
Sonia Artero, TVB News.
Sports news. Hong Kong swimmer Siobhan Hawley has gone through to the women's 200 meters freestyle final at the FINA World Aquatics Championships in Hungary. And turning to tennis, 12-time Grand Slam champion Novak Djokovic is set to miss the rest of the year to recover from an elbow injury. Jeff Tang has the story.
Bad news for Novak Djokovic fans. The former world number one announced earlier this evening that he's going to sit out the rest of the 2017 season to nurse an injured right elbow that has bothered him for more than a year. It was the same injury that forced him to retire from his Wimbledon quarterfinal match against Thomas Berdych earlier this month. The Serb said this is the decision that had to be made at this moment. That means the 30-year-old will pull out of the US Open in September, ending his active streak of taking part in 51 consecutive Grand Slam tournaments. Until now, Djokovic has never missed a major tournament since he entered his maiden Grand Slam, the 2005 Australian Open. That's the third longest active run among men and the seventh longest in history. Just last month, Djokovic was ranked outside the top two for the first time since March 2011 after losing in the quarterfinals of the French Open. The current world number four is almost certain to finish the year outside the top five for the first time in over a decade. Jeff Tang, TVB News.
Final look at the weather before we go. It will be mainly cloudy, interspersed with very hot and sunny periods. Temperatures will top 33 degrees. And that's the news. Thanks for watching. Good night.